the love of printing was always present at, when I was at art school in the 60s. I had to be dragged screaming from the print room to do the proper work, as they called it, the typography and the conceptual work. And then after I left art school and went to work in advertising and as a freelance, I never went back to it until the early 90s, when I went into lecturing and taught on an illustration course, finally became head of department and had the print room, which was closed, and then I opened it up and got students interested. That revived my interest until it became an obsession, really. And then when I retired, I got a press, by devious means, some would say, and started printmaking, and now it is an obsession. Okay, the press that I use is an old Victorian press. It's a standard pattern, you get all kinds of them. Sadly, mine is a smaller one, but there are economies and you use less paper and you use less ink as well. It's a Hopkins & Cope. I think it was 1874 it was built. And there's only one bolt on it that isn't original. The rest of it is completely original and it still works like clockwork. When we moved to West Norfolk, we brought it up. An engineer took it apart in Sandhurst, put it back together up here after an overhaul. And it fired up straight away. Fired up isn't quite the right word, but it worked from the off and it's never blinked since. Absolutely trouble free, as long as you remember to oil it. When we lived in Sandhurst, one of the first things that I did was a Christmas card which featured the Jack Russell we had then, the brilliantly named Pike, who had a set of teeth like a pike as well, I would add. And from those small cards, the print developed, being a supporter of Middlesbrough Football Club. I did a set of football prints. I've got some of them signed by some of the players from those early days in the 90s, people like Stuart Downing and Mark Schwarzer, who was the goalkeeper. And then when we moved, a focus came, and it's the landscape in Fenland. A lot of people see the landscape, they don't give it a blink because they think it's simply as flat as a witch's tit and there's nothing to be seen anywhere. But if you look at it with a degree of care, there's a lot goes on in the landscape. The seasons, the colours, the textures, the whole thing, and the skies sitting on top are absolutely stunning. They're a bit like, in a way, Dutch sea paintings without the sea.